The Philippine and U.S. defense chiefs jointly criticized China's dangerous actions in the West Philippine Sea. They spoke during a visit to the Philippine military's Palawan headquarters, which guards the troubled waterway. Bianca Dava has this story.
China has been consistently denying the Philippines the right to access its exclusive economic zone in the West Philippine Sea, according to Defense Secretary Gilberto Chodoro Jr. Chodoro made this comment in a press conference held at the Armed Forces of the Philippines Western Command in Palawan on Tuesday.
It's the same story over and over again. They have placed a lot of these pseudo-military vessels, disguised as Coast Guard vessels and maritime militia vessels in the areas of the West Philippine Sea. They have been very aggressive in their information operations against the Philippines.
Chodoro explained Beijing's aggression towards Manila was further highlighted by the fact that the Chinese issued comments on the newly signed General Security of Military Information Agreement, or GSOMIA, between the Philippines and the U.S.
All of these actions, to me, prove the existence of some motive which is brought about by a closed political system where the external controls the internal political environment.
China claims almost the entire South China Sea and has brushed aside a 2016 ruling by the Permanent Court of Arbitration in The Hague that its sweeping claims were not supported by international law. The China Coast Guard and maritime militia have been harassing, blocking, and executing dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels conducting legitimate maritime operations, particularly in Ayungin Shoal, Escoda Shoal, and Panatag Shoal. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin III agreed with Chodoro and described China's behavior in the South China Sea as concerning. He reiterated Washington's commitment to Manila under the Mutual Defense Treaty.
When it comes to our Mutual Defense Treaty, what we have emphasized, we remain committed to the treaty. We stand with the Philippines and we condemn dangerous actions by the PRC against lawful Philippine operations in the South China Sea. We'll continue to work with our allies and make sure that we're doing the right thing to promote a secure and open Indo-Pacific.
Chodoro and Austin visited the WESCOM headquarters as part of their bilateral engagements. They also observed a demonstration of a T-12 unmanned surface vessel, one of the capabilities the U.S. has provided to the Philippine Navy through foreign military financing. Meanwhile, Austin is optimistic that Philippine-U.S. Defense Alliance will transcend changes in administrations. He believes the Philippines will remain an important ally for the U.S. for many years to come.
I can't tell you what I know. What I know is that I've seen strong support for the Philippines in both parties in the United States. And my guess is that we'll continue to see that going forward. That's evident to most people. And I think, it's in our best interest, as I said before, both of our best interests, to continue to develop the relationship and help the Secretary meet his goals in terms of modernization so that, he can continue to protect his sovereign interests and the people of the Philippines.
For Chodoro, aside from being treaty allies, Manila's partnership with Washington stands for upholding international law and values of freedom and democracy. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.